Welcome back into the second quarter here on TexanLive.com. Mark M. Johnson along with Forrest Cox and our production engineers Kyle Ackerman and Reed Harmon. 7-0 Crosby on top of C.E. King, though C.E. King with the ball in their own territory, starting about their 36-yard line, a 2nd and 7 coming for them. Here's a quick pass from Desmond, almost intercepted, broken up nicely on the far side.
And it was number 29, Jalen Howard on the breakup for the Cougars. As you said, a fantastic play on the outside, forcing the punters into punt formation.
So I guess that was a 3rd down play. I was mistaken. I thought it was a 2nd down. So punt coming up for C.E. King. Back in his own 25-yard line, ready to receive this one. And a fair catch eventually called on the 31-yard line by Shane Hudson.
I will say one thing, too. Both punters doing a good job tonight so far, pinning these teams pretty deep. The only time Panthers actually had good field positioning was after a personal foul call, but both teams started around the 30-yard line all night. Always beneficial when you have a good special teams player like that.
We do have a score for you at the end of one Manville, and our 6A game of the week is up on Pearland 10-7. Around the corner on 1st down, probably losing yardage on the play, was the sophomore running back Williams.
The Panthers continue to do a good job flying to the ball here. Really playing a good defensive front so far against this tough Crosby Cougar offense.
Only a 7-0 game. There's a flea flicker. You don't see that too often. But nothing downfield. And just taking it back up to the line of scrimmage.
Netherly wanted Gray Brooks deep around the left side, but well covered and well executed by the Panthers. Forcing 3rd down and long.
About a minute has gone by here in the second quarter. Cotton looking to throw. And that pass. Can't tell. Was that complete? That was incomplete. So that'll bring up 4th down. Punt team coming on.
Tell C. King Panthers really came ready to play, well prepared for this high-powered Crosby Cougar offense that's been leading district in stats so far. C. King top 5 in district, but ranked number 4, really playing a fantastic ball game on the defensive side of the football.
That they have. Here to kick this one away is Jordan Hill, and they're just going to let this bounce, and it's going to take a Cougar bounce, a fantastic one. Around the 30-yard line is going to bounce back to about the 16-yard line in C.E. King territory.
Another good punt from the C.E. King, or excuse me, from the Crosby Cougar offense, pinning the C.E. King Panther offense deep. They got a long way to score. Granted, you got plenty of time here in the second quarter. You're only down 7, but got to get that offense rolling. Jonathan Brantley's got to get his crew going.
Now 10:50 left in the first quarter, or second quarter, excuse me. C.E. King trailing 7-0. Four wide receiver set, one in the backfield for them. Taking it himself is Desmond. Spins away from a tackle, across the 20-yard line. Pick up some pretty productive yardage here.
Nice run for the Panthers right there. It seems like neither team trying to do too much so far. Looking for somebody eventually to take a shot deep at the end zone. You saw the Panthers try to do it once. You saw the Cougars trying to do it on a flea flicker, but that's about it tonight.
Yeah, everybody being very cautious right now as this handoff goes up the middle close to the 1st down. looks to be about a yard shy up to the 25-yard line.
Number 90, Jose Mendez, making another play for the Cougars, a senior defensive lineman, 5'11", 270.
Panthers making a couple of adjustments. And now they're running a trips left. One on the right side as they stop the play. And a timeout is going to be called by C.E. King to talk things over real quick. 9:42 left in the first half. Crosby with a 7-0 lead over C.E. King. You're listening to TexanLive.com.
If you want a real authentic Texas barbecue, you need to come to Tin Roof. We've been doing barbecue for 12 years, and we've just a little mom and pop barbecue joint where everything is cooked fresh here. We have brisket, sausage, chicken that's cooked fresh every day, ribs cooked fresh every day. We have the world's best turkey, and then we do like 15 side dishes, and the side dishes are all from scratch. On Friday and Saturday night, we have live music. We'll have a band playing outside. So if you get a chance, come by and see me.
Back from that C.E. King timeout, talking things over here on third and very short. They're going to want to take every precaution necessary in this game, I'm quite certain. Running a trips right, the Panthers are going to run the ball, and they're going to be stopped. They actually lose yardage on the play.
Another fantastic stand from this Crosby Cougar defense. And, you know, if you're Coach Price of the C.E. King Panthers, you have to punt the football here. And Crosby Cougars doing a fantastic job. They keep it up on that defensive front, getting good penetration into that backfield.
The timeout didn't seem to help. As the punt team comes on, ready to kick it away. Hudson around his own 31-yard line. Set to receive, and it's a high snap. And just getting the kick away, falling on the 35-yard line and coming backwards a little bit. Crosby is going to have great field position.
And I'm going to give it to Hudson on that one. A very, very, very smart play. You saw the guys in your face just trying to get the ball off any way you can instead of taking a sack and giving the ball at the one-yard line. At least you pin them around the 30, it's like the 33-yard line. A smart play from C.E. King Panthers. But as you said, Crosby's got great field positioning, putting themselves to take an early 14-0 lead.
Morales reminded me of some game I saw. What was it? Michigan? Michigan State?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. He got that one off, though.
Update from another game here in 21-5A. It's 14-14, Dayton and Porter. Surprising score out there.
Wow. The handoff up the middle from Crosby is good for about 3 yards. It'll be second and seven up to the 30-yard line. Did you just say it was 14-14?
It's 14-14. A young Porter offense taking it to the Dayton Broncos tonight in a game that they need to win to go into the third seed spot here in District 21-5A.
Goodness. Here's a pass to Netherly, broken up very nicely in the secondary.
Like Tyler Jolvet on that play for C. King. But exactly you said, fantastic breakup as a play. If Netherly catches that ball, he's in there for a touchdown.
Almost all the time you see it go to Netherly, you just assume he's going to catch it. Here's another passing play going to Netherly once again, pushing off, making the catch, and in the end zone for a touchdown. Looking over there for a flag as he appeared to be pushed out of the way was Francis, but no flag, and Netherly puts Crosby up by 2 scores.
Great job there also by quarterback Tristan Cotton going through his progression, threw the ball to his playmaking receiver, and sure enough, despite the push-off, refs didn't call it. I mean, is what it is, but a great job just making the play on that football.
He made it happen, and here is the PAT drilled up and good. 14-0 is your score. Crosby on top of CE King with 8:12 left here in the first half. You're listening to TexanLive.com.
AllSpas is so much more than Ace Hardware. Sure, we have nuts and bolts, lawn and garden, faucets and fixtures, lights and locks, even outdoor cooking. But AllSpas is also a boutique featuring the finest names in jewelry and home accessories. But most importantly, AllSpas is a friendly, helpful family of people who take pride in their products and services. AllSpas is Ace Hardware and so much more.
Back here on TexanLive.com, touchdown from Netherly, second grab of the night, makes it 14-0. This guy just keeps coming away with plays.
He's been doing that all night long. You talked about him being the ultimate athlete earlier in the game, and sure enough, he's proven himself tonight. Just a junior, another guy that's going to be returning here for the Crosby Cougar offense.
Here is another pooch kick we saw last time. This one almost going Crosby's favor, but just making the catch around the 25-yard line and going, just stepping out of bounds wisely was Desmond Coleman. So they'll start the ball off around the 24-yard line, actually. Once again, 8:12 remain here in this first half. C.E. King and Crosby playing for the 21-5A district title. Throwing it downfield. He's got a man open, and he's going to underthrow him, but coming back to make the catch. Did he hold on to it? Yes, he did. An unbelievable catch made by the man who just made the receiving kickoff right there, Desmond Coleman.
Hey, you say, hold on a second. Emmanuel Netherly, I know you can make plays, but Desmond Coleman just made a huge one too for the CE King Panthers.
Another pass out to the right side. This one is going to be tackled in the backfield for a loss around the 40-yard line.
Two other scores out of 21-5A tonight. It's surprising over here at Dayton High School, 14-14. Dayton Broncos and the Porter Spartans with 5:06 remaining in the second quarter, and Humble up 28-0 on Galena Park with 11:25 left in the second.
Here's a pass complete around the 30-yard line. Close to the first down, about a yard shy after making that catch. Nicola with the reception.
First really sign of life from this offense so far since the very first drive of the game from the Panthers. See if they can't keep this one going and put it in the end zone.
Running a trips right, one on the left side. One in the backfield in his shotgun. Quick throw up the middle. Pass is complete. Good for the first down. That's all they needed, and that ball is taken up to the 23-yard line in Cougar territory.
Brantley had Rashad Singleton in his face, and a fantastic job getting rid of that ball, throwing it over Singleton, allowing his receiver to make a play on it.
So McCullough with the reception gives them a fresh set of downs. That pass is just off target, intended for Reginald McCullough.
Had McCullough open in the flat, probably would have gotten the first down and had a man to beat for the touchdown if that one was on the money. But that's one, if something happens later on this ball game, that's one you're going to want back at the end of the night.
Yeah, those ones always hurt. He puts that one on target, and you're right, Forrest, that very well could have been a race to the end zone. So here they go with the second and 10. Pass is short again. I'm surprised he caught that one in the backfield, and he is just ambushed there by all of the Cougars.
Well, they did a fantastic job. They read screen that whole play, and that's what it was, and they bring him down for a loss of about 3 yards. And You know, we saw it earlier. We saw the Panthers get something going. They got inside Cougar territory about the same yardage spot. Had this same situation third down long, able to get to fourth down and short, but couldn't convert. What are they going to do here on this drive?
Running a trips right. They need to get to the 13-yard line. They're going to throw that ball, and it's just over the head and out of the reach of the intended receiver. If he caught that ball, he's falling into the end zone for the touchdown.
Second time on this drive, he's looked for Desmond Coleman. He made a play earlier to get them this deep in this territory, and you see the offensive coaches for the Panthers. They want that one back, but you got fourth down and long, and it looks like he's going to send the field goal unit out on the team, which are out on the field, and I can't tell if Brantley's going to stay out there. No, it looks like field goal team is coming in. Smart thing you're going to do, just take some points, get on the scoreboard any way you can.
So I'm guessing they wish they would have done that to start the game off. If they had that opening drive, they could have taken an early 3-0 lead. Instead, went for it on fourth and short and came up short. And a timeout is going to be taken by C.E. King once again to try to make sure they get this thing right. So with 5:50 left here in the first half, Crosby still with a 14-0 lead on C.E. King. You're listening to TexanLive.com.
If you want a real authentic Texas barbecue, you need to come to Tin Roof. We've been doing barbecue for 12 years, and we're just a little mom-and-pop barbecue joint. Everything is cooked fresh here. We have brisket, sausage, chicken that's cooked fresh every day, ribs cooked fresh every day. We have the world's best turkey, and then we do like 15 side dishes, and the side dishes are all from scratch. On Friday and Saturday night, we have live music. We'll have a band playing outside, so if you get a chance, come by and see.
Welcome back into TexanLive.com. A 43-yard field goal is about to be attempted by Jonathan Morales. Here it is. It has the distance. Is it good? It is. Impressive kick. Probably could have cleared nearly 50 on that one. And they are on the board 14-3. Still trailing Crosby, though, with C.E. King.
Now, we talked about it earlier on the punt situations, about the punters, both sides of the ball pinning each other deep. And it really benefits you. I know you're still down 14-3, but you got some points on the scoreboard if you're the Panthers. And not a lot of high school kickers able to hit from that distance. 43-yard, a pretty good long, pretty long field goal in high school sports, and a good job by Coach Price trusting in his kicker. Knew he had the ability to make that one.
It is a hard thing to trust these kickers in high school to make a 40-plus yard field goal, but probably why we didn't see that in the first drive. I know they want to take a big lead, or at least they want to get as many points as they possibly can on Crosby, especially early. So that's probably why we didn't see that field goal early in this game by C.E. King. Would have been a shorter field goal, too.
Well, if you're the Panthers now here on this drive, you got to figure out a way to force a turnover and get that ball back in your favor. You've got time on the clock, but you know, the same way Crosby Cougars coming out ready to score again. You saw them take an early 14-0 lead before that last drive. So great battle here tonight at Crosby Cougar High School.
5:46 remain in this first half. Morales is set to kick. And it's going to be a good one. Way deep in his own end zone. Just kneeling on it is the Crosby Cougar returner. So they'll bring it out to the 25-yard line.
C.E. King, other than two real drives, you know, it was two. Well, one on the first drive, you know, he got called for holding a couple times if you're the Crosby Cougar offense. But so far, other than those two drives, C.E. King offenses, our defense has really played pretty well. They need to keep it up and go back to what was working here on the previous drives.
Starting on their own 25, Cotton hands the ball off. And it looks like falling over. Might have been tripped up. But gets about a yard on the play after being tripped. That was Craig Williams on the carry.
And Jesse Weston on the stop for the Panthers.
Here's a second and nine. Another run across the 30 to about the 31-yard line. This time Edwards on the carry.
And a great job by McKay making basically a long run breaking tackle on that stop. If he gets by McKay, you know, Edwards had plenty of daylight there on the left side of the field.
.445 and ticking here in the first half. Crosby with a 14-3 lead with the ball. In the shotgun is Cotton. He's going to fake a throw to the right side and take it himself up the middle for the first down. Pickup of about 6 or 7 on the play.
That brings up another Crosby Cougar.
With a fresh set of downs. Taking it up the middle once again is Edwards. He picks up some pretty productive yardage across the 40 to about the 42-yard line. So a second and about 4 or 5 coming up. One in the backfield with Cotton. He's going to look downfield. He's going to see Netherly about the 25-yard line. He makes the catch, comes down with it, and he's going to spot the ball around the 21-yard line. Another fantastic catch by Manny Netherly.
Oh, and you got to give it to Tristan Cotton, too, just throwing it up. I mean, he was in man-to-man coverage there across the middle, but Cotton really trusts Netherly to go up and make a play on that ball, and you see what happens that time. Great play by Netherly, and now they're really knocking at the Panthers' door again.
Netherly heads to the sideline, a much-deserved break. Hand off to Edwards. Across the 10, inside the 10 now, to about the 8-yard line. A first and goal coming up for Crosby after that run by Travion Edwards.
Well, we talked about it as the drive started. If you're the Panthers, figure out a way to force a turnover here.
Quickly back to the snap. Edwards has got it. He's going around the right side, but a couple of Panthers stop him in the backfield. He might take a loss on that one. It did take more than one Panther to stop him in the backfield. Nonetheless, they got the job done. So the ball backed up to about the 9 or 10-yard line as a flag goes down.
Probably going to be a neutral zone infraction. Saw him touch his hips. Usually the sign for offsides or neutral zone, but you saw the nose tackle. The Panthers kind of jumped that line of scrimmage, causing the Crosby Cougar center to fall start.
So moving the ball up even further. Williams, a sophomore, up the middle, and Crosby has himself another touchdown and increased their lead.
Just one of those things. You knew this Panther defense was really going to have to step up. They stepped up in the first quarter, but maybe getting a little tired so far tonight. And now they find themselves in a big hole. They still got time to score before halftime, but down 21, or pending extra point, 21-3.
This is a pretty tough deficit right now as Ochoa puts this one up and through. And now Crosby has a 21-3 lead with 2:40 left in this first half. We'll take a quick break and be right back here on TexanLive.com.
AllSpas is so much more than Ace Hardware. Sure, we have nuts and bolts, lawn and garden, faucets and fixtures, lights and locks, even outdoor cooking. But AllSpas is also a boutique featuring the finest names in jewelry and home accessories. But most importantly, All Spas is a friendly, helpful family of people who take pride in their products and services. All Spas is Ace Hardware, and so much more.
Texan Live is your new home for Houston High School sports. Three games on tap tomorrow. Get started early with an 11 a.m. kickoff as the undefeated Katy Tigers face the undefeated Cinco Ranch Cougars with the District 19-6A title on the line. Michael Silvers and Bert Brocker will have that one. Elsewhere, Lou Roche and myself will have Turner Stadium tomorrow night as Barbersville takes on Kingwood Park. Kickoff is at 2 p.m. And the nightcap features Tompkins and Katy Taylor at 6 p.m. Derek Jones and Greg Beatty will have the call for that one.
Some good games on tap tomorrow. That Cinco Ranch Katy game, looking to shape up to be a good one.
I know both of those teams have been looking forward to that one all season long. Biggest challenge for both teams. Pooch kick coming once again, as we saw before. Fielded at the 20. This time he's going to take it. And he's not going to get very far. Probably gets one or two on the return. That one was taken this time by Tyler Joliet. Desmond Colin was the last one to take the reception.
Cougars continue to do a good job downfield covering on special teams. Once again, the Panthers have a long way to go, Mark. You see it so many times in high school sports. You don't get the benefit of having good kickers as you have on the Crosby Cougar side and City King Panther side of the football. But, you know, 2:33 left here in the half. Panthers got a long way to go.
Funny thing about it, a lot of the kickers play in the field. Five wide receivers, but taking it himself and being tackled in the backfield for about a one-yard loss. Brantley just couldn't get any more forward.
It's a good buddy of mine on that stop, Alec Lewis. Knew him when he was a freshman over at Atascocita, transferred over to Crosby last year, and great to see him making plays like that here in this ballgame.
We've seen a few former Eagles on both sides, huh?
Yes, sir. Exactly.
Eagles, of course, finishing second over at 16-6A this season once again. Brantley, pass incomplete around the 27-yard line. Brown was the intended receiver.
And unfortunately, one of those you got to catch. You know, you were in a position to make a play, just couldn't hang on to the ball. And now you find yourself once again in a tough third down and long situation. Not the first time the Panthers have found themselves in that situation tonight. Crosby Cougar defense still doing a fantastic job flying to the ball on third down.
Brantley is going to run it. He's got a lot of space ahead of him. He will be shy of the first down, tackled around the 30-yard line in his own territory. And a timeout will be taken down on the field. So we'll take a quick break and be right back right here on TexanLive.com.
If you want a real authentic Texas barbecue, you need to come to Tin Roof. We've been doing barbecue for 12 years, and we've just a little mom and pop barbecue joint. Everything is cooked fresh here.
Fans, make sure to log on to TexanLive.com each and every week to vote for Cavender's Player of the Week. Then tune in every Friday night into the Houston High School Football Wrap-Up Show presented by Texan Drive to see who Courtney Madden showcases as a Cavender's Player of the Week on Fox Sports Southwest. We have ourselves a 21-3 game here with 1:32 left in the half. C.E. King ready to punt the ball back over to Crosby. And Crosby is going to have pretty good field position, it looks like, pending a wonderful kick. Here's the punt. It's going to go out of bounds around the 45-yard line into Crosby territory, not giving Shane Hudson a chance to return it.
I think so far, this is other than the Other than the bad snap earlier, this is the best field position the Cougars have had so far. 1:24 remaining here in the first quarter. Cougars, I believe, have two timeouts left. Scoreboard not functioning right, unfortunately, here at Crosby High School, but you know they're trying for another one here.
They definitely want to put some more points up before the end of the half, and they have plenty of time to do it, especially from this range. Pass over to Netherly around the 40-yard line from Cotton is going to go incomplete.
Just in and out of his hands. He had it, almost secured it, and just popped out of his hands at the last second.
Had he caught that, it would have been very close to a first down. But as it is, it'll be second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line in CE King territory. Cotton stepping back out of the pocket. He's being chased, running into trouble. Run across the field, now throw it towards Netherly, and once again, he is unable to come up with a catch as it goes through his hands as he was covered heavily.
I'm going to give a gold star on that one to Micah Edwards, one of the offensive line for the Cougars. Really did a good job blocking and helping Tristan Cotton get a couple extra seconds to throw that ball. Cotton had plenty of time, almost 6-7 seconds to get rid of that one.
And that's what these quarterbacks are going to need. That's why he's found Netherly, is great blocking there on the line. Cotton looking downfield again. That pass almost complete in between defenders. Over to Travion Edwards, but another incomplete pass. Three straight, stopping the clock at 101. Will be now a fourth down for Crosby. They will surprisingly be going for it here. Nope, they're going to punt it away. It looked like they're going to just let it go. And then this one is going to be down to the 1-yard line. That is an impressive play there from the Cougars, having C.E. King think that they're going to go for it, stepping back, punting the ball when there's nobody in the backfield, letting it roll all the way to the 1-yard line.
Well, it always helps when you got a player like Tristan Cotton that's not only a quarterback, but he's got a decent leg on him, and you can quick kick the ball like that on fourth down. It really works out to the Cougars' advantage. And now a minute, or check that, 51 seconds remaining on the clock in the first half. Panthers got 99 yards to go. They have had trouble moving the ball against this Crosby Cougar defense so far tonight.
And right now it looks like probably their main concern is just getting out of this end zone without allowing any more points. They're going with the trips right. There's some movement there on the line as the pass goes downfield towards the 35-yard line, incomplete, out of bounds, intended for Coleman.
I really like the aggressive call of C. King throwing that deep fade ball up, trying just to make a spark here deep in Cougar territory. Deep in your own territory, excuse me.
Porter, very good coverage there on the right side. Now running the ball out of the end zone, just trying to get some breathing room up to the 5-yard line. Diving forward there is Travion Williams. 30 seconds now remain.
Clock continues to kick. Look like the Panthers may just try to get out of this half unscathed and not really worried about trying to score. Just going to run one final play. If that play clock hadn't even started, they may not even have to run a play left in this half.
Yeah, now down to 10 seconds. I mean, that seems like the logical thing to do. Just get out of this one. Cut your losses here in the first half and start over. Not going to do anything here in the field position they have. Indeed, it will take us to the end of the first half. Crosby with a big first half on offense and defense, 21-3. They take the lead into halftime over C.E. King. Halftime presented by Panera Bread. We'll see you after the half here on TexanLive.com.
At Panera, we decided a long time ago to avoid the easy road and switch to antibiotic-free chicken. That decision set a lot of things in motion, So now it's not just chickens raised this way. It's more ingredients you can trust. Which has taught us a lesson. Sometimes, what you think is the harder road turns out to be the only one worth being on. Panera Bread. Live consciously. Eat deliciously.